Children of 9th standard, here I am going to explain the poem Tiger, written by K.K. N. Daruwala. Warm up activity, discuss in pairs or groups. List some endangered animals. You must make a list of dangerous animals. Why are they considered endangered? Why are they dangerous? Do you think it is right to kill animals? Whether it is right to kill animals, whether they are dangerous or not dangerous? What happens if the wildlife is affected? If the wildlife is affected, what will be the result of it? These are the questions to you put. So, you make a list, try to answer the questions in warm-up activity. Now I will read the poem. Such one poem, a contradictory poem to this, written by William Blake. It is Tiger, Tiger, Burning Bright. And here K.K. Daruwala says, Tiger isn't burning bright. So, Tiger isn't burning bright. I will read this poem, I will explain it. Either in shadow or in sun. Shadow means night, or in sun means during daytime or nighttime. Tiger is not burning bright. Previously in William Blake's poem, Tiger was burning bright because because wild animals were not killed at that time. So here the tiger isn't burning bright either in shadow or in sun. Shadow means night, sun means daytime. Now the tiger is not burning bright, no fear. The tiger family is thinning. The family of the tiger means all the tigers are becoming less and less, thinning. Two by two and one by one. They are killed one, two. Every day the tigers are killed. The tiger isn't burning bright. Now there is no power of the tiger. In the forest of the night, even in the forest at night, or in the wilderness of day, or during daytime, tiger is not burning bright. We need to understand his plight. We must understand the bad situation, bad fate of the tigers now. The father Sheru is missing now. Sheru means strong. So it is called Sher. Sheru, it's an Hindi word, Sher. So now Sheru means tiger. Now the Sheru, the main tiger, is missing now. Sheru has been shot and skinned. Sheru has been killed and his skin is removed. Poachers ground his bones to powder. The hunters, they ground this tiger's bone and they make powder for Chinese medicine. They make the powder of the bones as a medicine. That is, they prepared a Chinese medicine. Bones would bring them power, they thought. These people think that if you eat the powder of the bones of the tiger, then it will give you power. Put life into some sickly man. If a man is sick, if you give this powder to him, the sick man will be cured. Their souls were sick, killing tigers. They are killing tigers is something we won't understand. What is this killing the tiger? We don't understand whether by the powder the sick man will get through his sickness. His skin is hanging on the wall. Now, after killing the tiger, there are some crazy people who keep the skin of the tiger on the table or somewhere for show. They keep on the chair and sit on that. And the skin now, it is hanging on the wall, the dead tiger skin. His bones are packed in plastic white. That tiger's, killed tiger's bones are packed and shipped out, and they are sent by ship. A gecko on the wall. Now see, what is the quality of the tiger? What is the strength of the gecko? Gecko means a small tropical lizard of reptile class. He is hunting insects on his hide. Hide means skin. On the skin of the tiger, insects are sitting there. And this gecko is going to hunt the prey, that is the insect, to eat the insects. Once jungle trembled at his roar. There was a time when tiger used to roar, all jungle used to tremble. Trees tops flew up, birds disappeared. Tree tops flew. Means even tree tops trembled, and birds flew away from there. Monkeys screamed, what an uproar. Monkeys, they screamed, they screeched. They said, what an uproar. Now geckos nimble on his ear. Now geckos have become stronger than tiger. They are nimbling into his ears. Lord God has stamped upon his skin. See how God has made, he has made stripes on his skin. In equal stripes are there, both night and down. Night means black, down means, that is, white means, or yellow. Yellow and black, these stripes are there. His black and gold won't shimmer now. Now his black and gold, those stripes, they are not shining. Boar hunter, forest king has gone. Now, the forest king, who is called the tiger, who is called the king, is no more. He has gone. Sheru has gone. Jeru has gone. Sheru has gone. The tigers are diminishing day by day. It is a thing that we should not kill wild animals. This is the explanation. This is the meaning of the poem. The poet K.K.N. Daruwala has expressed his unhappiness about the dwindling numbers of the tiger in jungle. Dwindling means diminishing, becoming less. He is showing his disapproval at the treatment given to the tiger. See what bad treatment is given to the tiger because they are killed. And other wild animals that are part of the beauty of this world. Actually, wild animals are the beauty of the nature. They are beauty of the world. He sadly says that the tiger is no more the leader of the jungle. Now the tiger is no more the king of the jungle. The family of the, or the number is dwindling. The family of the tigers is becoming less and less day by day. He is mercilessly killed by humans for their selfishness. Why humans are killing? For their own selfishness. Because human beings have become selfish. Humans are killing in the pretext of using their bones for making them powerful. Why humans are killing them? They are using the bones, they are making powder of it. Why they are making powder? To become strong. Humans want to become strong. The poachers are killing them for their skin. The poachers, the hunters, are killing them for their skin. He sadly recalls how the tiger used to roar and frighten other animals in the wild, how tiger used to roar previously in the jungle, and how other animals got scared, birds got scared, how majestic he looked and moved majestically in the jungles, how proudly he used to move majestically. Today geckos nimble on his nose. Now what is the condition? Geckos are playing on his ears. Today tiger is at the verge of extinction. Now tigers, one day, if you go on killing the tigers, one day this tiger class will not be there. They will be in extinction, and it is very rare to have a view of this animal. Then it is not possible to see tiger at all. He appeals to the human beings to think about protecting the animals. He makes an appeal. Poet makes an appeal to the public, to the people, that they should not kill tiger, they must protect not only tiger, any other animal come out of his sick, thinking of killing them with some or the other pretext. Means somehow we are killing the tigers and this should be stopped forever. Thank you, children. Thank you very much. See, you read the poem once or twice, write down the poem and write the glossary words and write down the question answers on this lesson.